Hello everyone, and thank you for joining us for this new video in which Herman Boer, mechanical engineer and industrial designer at Over Studio, explains how to design plastic injection molds from a complete assembly designed on Autodesk Fusion 360. This is the third video in this series of introductory workshops on plastic injection molding, so if you missed any of the previous videos, I'll leave you the links in the description. Today, we're in the design of HoliMaker in Metz, and Herman are waiting for us in Nancy at Over Studio. So, without further ado, I hand it over to him.
Together, we're going to take a look at how to design a plastic injection mold made using 3D printing. The first step is to change the scale of the part you wish to inject to increase its volume. In fact, because of the shrinkage of the plastic, the injected part will be smaller than its initial size. Now that we've got our part at the right scale, we insert it into an assembly where we create the mold. The aim is to place the part in the right place in relation to the injection mold and the reference frame. In this case, we're going to inject from the center of the part, we'll therefore place the part in the center of the reference frame. This step is also used to create future products. For example, in this case, the top and bottom parts of the mold, which will be constrained for later use. In the second part, we define the mold's dimensions, so you need to add at least a centimeter of thickness to the edge of the part so that the mold is rigid enough. Now we'll use the surface tools to offset the surfaces needed to create this part of the mold, and we join these surfaces to the edge of the mold, creating the parting line. Finally, we join the surfaces together to create a solid. We've just seen how to make the upper part of the mold, and now we repeat the operations to create the lower part, which is the outer part of the mold. Once the surfaces have been joined to create the solids, we now place the injection gate. There is no direct contact between the nozzle and the mold. That's why we create a housing for a washer that will act as the interface between the nozzle and the mold, as well as the runners that will join the injection gate to the part. Here we create the vents that will allow air to escape during plastic injection. The screw bosses are created using inserts, in this case, ejector pins. This makes it possible to simply replace elements that might be very fragile if 3D printed. Fillets are created throughout the mold to conserve and save resin during printing. Now it is time to add the two alignment pins that allow us to position the upper part with the lower part of the mold. We come to the end, where we create the clamping system, in this case, using a screw. This is the element that counteracts the plastic injection pressure and closes the mold. We now add the standard elements and create the notches that will enable the mold to be opened with a screwdriver. Finally, we mark the name of the mold on each part and perform the final finishing touches, the mold analysis and verifications before the export. Then we export the mold in STL file. We now move on to the button mold, repeating the previous steps, which are positioning the part according to the injection gate, creating future products, offsetting the useful surfaces to the relevant part of the mold, defining the mold size, joining the surfaces together to create a solid, as well as repeating the same process to make the other part of the mold, in this case, adding inserts to stiffen a potentially fragile part if three-dimensional printed. We also add the fillets throughout the mold for saving materials. Then we add alignment pins to align the two parts of the mold during the closing phase. We place the injection gate and create the runners with the housing for the washer, which is here on the parting line. When the injection gate is in the parting line, it can be clamped in place with a vise. The air vents are added to evacuate the air. We create the chamfers, which will allow the part to be removed from the printing plate more easily, and we add notches to open the mold with a screwdriver. We add a name to each part of the mold so as not to get lost in the printing process, and before exporting to STL, we analyze the mold and check all the steps.
With our mold designs ready to print, we'll see you in the next video to follow the complete production process of our molds with the planning and preform, the 3D printing procedure, the washing and the curing, followed by the preparation of the molds to produce the first batches. If you have any questions, please ask us in the comments. Otherwise, thank you and see you soon.